Hello there, Cancer. Welcome to my channel. So today I am going to be doing your April 2021 love reading. So in this reading, I'm going to look at your overall energy with the oracle cards, and then we'll pull the tarot and get any further information that we need to about this month for you. So let's go ahead and start with the oracle cards. I've pulled them to save time with a shuffling, but I haven't taken a look at them yet. So let's see what we have. In perfect harmony, the number 11. Oh, Cancer, this is lovely energy. You know, this is the true soulmate, twin flame type of energy. So this is wonderful. It just means that, you know, you're on a path. If you're not with somebody right now that you think could be your twin flame, it means that this person is on your path, and you may actually almost, like, you know, have that feeling in your heart that the person is on their way because you are already in harmony with them. Really nice energy. Really nice. Angel balance. Yes, this person that is coming in is going to be very balancing in your life. You know, they're going to add to your life. They're not going to distract you in any way. So it's kind of a nice energy that they're going to, you know, your commitment with each other, your relationship will be very harmonious, very balanced. And if you're already in a relationship, it's that energy that your relationship is only going to get deeper and more harmonious over the next month. Lovely. Okay. Okay. So, and this is, you know, this is the conflict and defeat, you know, the Five of Swords, Five of Pentacles, feeling kind of, you know, abandoned. So we're going to get some information about this, but I'm really getting a sense. These two cards are just so lovely that if you've had some conflict with someone that you had a romantic, you know, relationship with in the past, they could be coming back and you're getting over the conflict that the two of you had. And if you're single right now, you could have left a relationship sometime in the past that had a lot of conflict, but you've overcome that. I feel like this is more of a sense of overcoming a sense of, you know, that abandonment, that conflict, feeling defeated in the eyes of love. So let's get some more information. So this is the twin flame oracle cards, but this is, I love the energy of these cards. So let's see what we have here. Divine timing, patience, perseverance, peace, trust that the divine knows when. And, you know, that kind of comes with the angel of balance. I think that you realize, and maybe after ending a relationship that was, you know, had a lot of conflict and pain in it, that there is something perhaps coming new into your life. Or for some of you, a reconciliation with this person from the past, because we have the twin flame energy. But that you understand that divine timing is playing out. That there may not be a lot you can do at this moment, except to keep your vibration high and keep, you know, your hopes alive for this. Okay, so let's see what else we have here. No, the answer to your question is no. So kind of interesting energy. You know, if you're thinking maybe this is somebody coming back from the past, it's almost like they're saying no, because it's kind of on this, you know, twin flame card. Like the person in the past, you may have thought that they were your twin flame or your soulmate, but this is saying no. This, you know, as if somebody new is coming in. I really have a sense of newness here. And journal, write, process, contemplate, understand your sacred journey. I'm really kind of getting the idea that this relationship in the past, you know, it was on your path because there was something that you had to learn. You had to go through this pain as part of your sacred journey because it's bringing in something that's so much more balanced. and harmonious for you. It's a really lovely energy. Lovely energy. Okay, so let's go to the tarot and see where this is going. So I'm going to do the Celtic cross. So I'll lay out the cross, and then we'll go back and clarify some of the cards to see what information we have. So you right now, Two of Wands. This is your present energy. You know, it's kind of interesting. I can't remember. It may have been Libra that got this, so you may be connected with a Libra. But the energy of, you know, she's looking out the window. Kind of like you may be looking at the past, but you're ready to go on a new adventure. You're ready to try for love again. And so this is you kind of like deciding, yes, it's time for me to kind of, you know, decide to move on from something in the past. Really interesting. Okay, so your obstacle is the Three of Wands. So you're at the Two of Wands, but you're not right. You're like not ready to take the first step to get out there. Really interesting. It's kind of a waiting energy. And, you know, since we have the No and the Divine Timing, I kind of have a sense that you may have to be, you're at the beginning of a new cycle with a Two and Three, but you may have to just kind of wait it out. So let's get some more information. So what's underneath you? Queen of Swords. You know, wow. I think we said that the Two of Wands, I think I had that in the Libra energy. This is more Libra energy here. So for some of you, you could really be, you know, dealing with a Libra, but you know, this is you kind of getting clarity about where you want to go. And, you know, it's interesting because of both of these cards, they're kind of looking to the future, looking out perhaps on the horizon, getting a clear vision about what they want out of love. And, you know, we have the, you know, the dove or a bird in the sky. You know, divine timing, spirit. You know, like this is really guided by spirit. I really get that sense. And especially with the harmonious card, I feel like, you know, you kind of know the direction you want to go in, but you're just not ready to step into it yet. So let's see what you're getting from your intuition. Seven of Swords. This could be you leaving something behind. It's also a card of self-denial, like denying yourself the true love. But this can also mean, you know, that you're, you know, that it's kind of a card of betrayal. Somebody stabbing you in the back. And that could be a past energy. We're definitely going to clarify some of these cards. So let's see what your recent past is. What energy do you have in your recent past? Two of Pentacles. Lots of beginnings here. So with the Two of Pentacles, it's kind of like you've been trying to decide, do I stay or do I go? You know, or you could have been juggling a couple of people and trying to decide what to do. So interesting. Interesting. Okay, so let's see what you have in the future. What's your future energy? Oh, the Wheel. Really nice. You know, that means that you have movement coming for, you know, in the very near future. I think for some of you, you do kind of feel stuck. You know, waiting for something to happen. You have the Two of Pentacles, the Two of Wands, the Three of Wands as an obstacle. I think you know what direction you want to go in. There could be somebody that is kind of, you know, holding you back in some way, either in your energy or, you know, the things that they're saying to you, kind of self-doubt. But you definitely, the wheel is going to turn. This divine timing is going to happen very soon. So what you have, oh yeah, this is what you're looking for. You're looking for balance. You're looking for justice, perhaps, with this Seven of Swords. If someone, you know, kind of betrayed you in the past or something, what you're really kind of deep down is looking for the truth. You're looking for truth. You're looking for balance. You're looking for a relationship that's balanced. And, you know, you have the Angel of Balance here. So it's about you finding balance within yourself and wanting balance in all areas of your life, including a romantic relationship. How nice. So this is your environment, the Fool. You're ready to start something new. Definitely. I mean, we definitely see that here. You're ready for the new. You're ready for something new. So what about your fears and wishes? Nine of Swords. You have a lot of, you know, this is the sleepless nights, the anxiety. You know, you have maybe some fears about starting something new, about this energy here. This could be your intuition telling you that the person you're with right now is somehow deceiving you, and you're worried about it. Or you could be possibly worried, you know, you have a lot of energy of moving on to something new, and you could be concerned that this person may stab you in the back when you leave, that kind of energy. Okay, so let's see what the outcome is. Oh, nice. Ace of Cups. Lovely energy. And, you know, with you have this energy here, the perfect harmony and perfect harmony. I think you know that there is love on the way for you. And I don't see anything here that's telling you you need to really have patience except the divine timing. But I kind of feel like you know that intuitively. You know that you just have to wait for the right time. For some of you, you may feel like you have to wait for the right time to leave a situation. That makes sense. Okay, so let's look at the Seven of Swords. Let's try to figure out the Seven of Swords. Transformation, oh my goodness, Empress energy, and Four of Cups. So I feel like, you know, whatever this Seven of Swords is, if this is somebody betraying you right now or someone that betrayed you in the past and it's kind of like still playing on your mind, you're transforming that. You want to become a loving and nurturing person. For some of you, this could be you self-sabotaging yourself in love. And you're transforming that. You're moving into someone that loves herself. And with this energy, I feel like you're going to get better at being discerning in love, if that makes sense. You know, she's kind of looking at these three cups, and she doesn't realize, like, you know, there's another cup over here. The true love is over here. The gift from the universe. And she's kind of looking at these, but she's not choosing one because she knows if she waits, something better is going to come in. And I think that for some of you, that's what you're doing. You know, you're kind of, some people, you might be very discerning at this time. And some people might say, oh, you're a little too picky. But what you're doing is you're actually transforming. You want a relationship that's really good for you, that's really grounded. You're ready to wait for the perfect harmony, right? You know that it's on its way and it's just a matter of time. Really nice. Okay, so let's look at this Two of Pentacles. What do we have here? Ten of Wands. Yeah, you're putting down the burdens of the past. You're putting all that down and you're ready to choose. And I think you're ready to choose you, right? Cancer, like, ready to choose to wait for the right one. Okay, so let's look at this Two of Wands. We have the Knight of Wands. You know, that's passion. Somebody, you know, very kind of like, you know, party oriented, that type of thing. But it also can be somebody that's kind of like a player. Comes in, comes out, you know, of your life very quickly. You may have dealt with those types of energies before. Yes, you've healed from that and you're wanting balance. You want somebody that's going to stick around. You're ready to wait. Sometimes if you've had a difficult relationship in the past, sometimes you go through that period where, you kind of like date everybody. you're just kind of like trying to heal and move on, whatever it takes. And I think you've come through that, and you went through maybe you were dating players, or you weren't putting your all into relationships, and you've healed that. You want something balanced. You want something that's really for the long term. Really nice. Okay, how about the Queen of Swords? What do we have here? Four of Pentacles. Yeah, you have your vision. But once again, it's kind of like you're holding out for what it is that you really want. Really nice. Okay, and with the, let's see, we have the Wheel here, Six of Cups. Oh dear. Let's get a couple more there. That's, somebody coming back from the past. So yeah, the Six of Cups, Three of Cups, Ace of Wands. All right, so for some of you, the Wheel is indicating a new start in a relationship from the past. So we have the Six of Cups, somebody coming back from the past, reconciling, celebrating that, right? And getting a fresh start in a past relationship. For others of you, I think, you could be looking to the past, and it could have been a third-party situation. And you've been inspired to know that you need to turn the wheel and break that pattern and go forward where it's only one person, right? Like you're not part of the party scene, right? You're not one of many. You're the single person in that person's life. So it really depends on your past situation. It'll resonate a little bit differently with different people depending on your scenario. But in either case, it's really where you're thinking, I want to be the solo person in somebody's life. I don't want somebody that is, dating around. I don't want to date around. I'm ready to give a relationship perfect harmony. The two ones. I want it just to be the two of us, if that makes sense. And it could be that you're looking for a long-term relationship, but right now I don't see that you're looking for the one. I think what you're doing is looking for a one, just wanting to have a relationship that's just one-on-one, a caring relationship. So let's see what the Justice is. Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, you want something balanced. This is the first card that shows, you may want something that's long-term. Ten of Pentacles is, something that goes the distance. Oh, Six of Wands, High Priestess. Yeah, you want something balanced that will go the long-term. And with the Six of Wands, that's victorious. For a lot of you that are looking at someone from the past, maybe returning, if that scenario is resonating with you, it's going to be victorious, and you know this. Like with the High Priestess, you know that no matter what your storyline is, that the relationship coming in is going to be long-term and victorious. You just know that, and that's why you're kind of like willing to wait for the right person to come along. And not to waste time, just dating anyone, because that the divine time is coming very soon, and that, you're going to have this fresh, new perspective in love, right? Something new. Oh, the Lovers, strength. Oh my goodness. Okay, well, Cancer, this is definitely you stepping into new love, making the choice that you do want love, that you want a single love, that you have the strength to wait it out, to wait for something that is long-term, victorious. This is like the wedding card, right? This is a lovely energy. Yes, very lovely, because you know these two cards together, it really does speak to having a twin connection or a true soulmate connection, and going the distance with that person. I just got the message that for some of you, you weren't quite ready for your soulmate connection yet. And it doesn't mean that in the past you didn't have people that you really cared about, but you knew you had to reach a certain maybe financial goal or a level of maturity, a level of stability and balance in your life before you were really ready for this. And now you are. It's really lovely. So let's take a look at this Nine of Swords, because everything is just so lovely here. Eight of Pentacles, Temperance, there's waiting, and Nine of Wands. So, I think that you're worried. Do you have the, you've been working on your finances. This is you working on your career, your finances, trying to balance and juggle everything in your life, but also trying to build healthy boundaries. In the past, you may not have had healthy boundaries if you were in relationships that, were kind of flighty or, here today, gone tomorrow type energy, just casual dating. You may not have had to build those healthy boundaries because your relationships were so, swift, right? Like, very passionate and then, gone and you're on to the next one. And it's not that you really wanted it that way. It was just maybe like a phase, a cycle you were going through. But now you have the healthy boundaries to allow a good relationship to come in and to have balance. And this is, allowing the divine timing too. You may be concerned, is it the right time? Have I done enough work? For some of you, have I done enough work on myself to be ready for this really lovely, soulmate connection? But you definitely are, because everything is just so positive. There's really nothing negative here. Okay, so we have the World. Lovely. Yeah, I think you're stepping into a whole new kind of King of Pentacles, the Magician, the King of Wands. Nice. Lots of King energy here. And I'm going to say that with these two kings, you may actually have a choice. The King of Wands, I'm going to say, could be this Knight of Wands from the past coming back and saying, I've leveled up, right? Like, I'm serious now, right? And putting a real offer on the table. And then you have a King of Pentacles, somebody who is financially stable, somebody that's really grounded. That can go the long haul. This is somebody that is willing to go the long haul. This one, this energy is a little bit more passionate, fiery, adventurous. This person is more responsible, kind of more grounded. And so I think you may have to make a choice. I think you have manifested, a new love in your life. You're stepping into a new world. And when you do, I think when you really make this decision that you really are ready for love, you're going to have choices. And those are two nice choices. Really lovely energy. Really lovely. Okay, so let's look at the Romance Oracle cards. Let's see what we have here to get some more information. Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. And, they just indicated you've spent a lot of time working, right? Working on yourself, working on your finances, working on getting your life balanced and, really just stable. You've done a lot of work and now it's time to have a little fun. And it doesn't mean like fun as in, dating around. It just means to just be playful when, you meet someone, to not be too serious about it all, right? To be a little bit playful with that person. Really nice. And very soon, clearly decide what you want so that comes to you now. Really nice energy. Super lovely. I do feel like this is right on the horizon, especially with this divine timing card that usually doesn't come unless it's really about to happen. Really nice. And calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help you, help bring you two together. Yes. Really nice energy. You definitely have love on the way, Cancer. Really lovely. Okay, so let's take a look at a love oracle card. And Cancer, if you've enjoyed this reading, I would really appreciate it if you would like, share, or subscribe. It really helps to build my channel and to get my message out there to more people. So let's see what your love oracle card is. Really nice. Forgiveness. Stop focusing your energy on past events, for life is too precious to waste. You create your reality by what you think, dream, and imagine. And you know, that's coming, you know, I think that it's kind of interesting how the artwork on both of these is so similar. And it's really about, you know, like, really look, I think it's interesting. Both of the females have their eyes closed, like they're really visualizing what it is that they want in their soulmate and really focusing on that. And then, you know, the two male angels kind of already know what's coming, right? It's kind of an interesting energy, and gender doesn't matter there. But I really do think that it's about forgiving whatever happened in the past. And sometimes, you know, that's also forgiving ourselves. You know, if you feel like you went through a time where you were casually dating, and maybe for too long or whatever, like it's about, don't worry about that. That's in the past. And you are stepping into such a beautiful future. So just forgive the past, whether it's, you know, you want to, you have regrets about things that you did, or if, you know, you need to forgive someone else. Well, this one just dropped out, so we're going to take it. It was kind of quick. Star, believe in yourself. You are a wonder of creation. Wash away all fear and discover you are a shining star. Allow all around you just to be. Let go of trying to control life, for the light of your soul will guide you always towards love. Remember, stars are born through explosions of love. Love illuminates all things. Never forget, you are truly a shining star. And I love that. I love that with the forgiveness, because sometimes, you know, we have to just forgive whatever happened in the past. You know, whether it's our actions or the actions of someone else, and just step into our light. And when we do that, we bring in more light. So it's just a beautiful reading. Cancer, I hope you enjoyed this reading. I really enjoyed doing it for you. I wish you lots of love and light in this situation and all your situations. Bye for now.